the
practice of working with ischemia. And, you okay, Charlotte?
Oh. Oh, good. It opened.
Hi. If you don't mind, my mom and I are going to sit in.
Oh, please.
I'm going to move a chair close to the side. Gorgeous.
Oh, do you need this?
Oh, okay.
Yes.
And there,
yeah, and there's more chairs here. In fact, I'm
going
to add a chair
okay.
for me because this is a little on the low side.
The chairs away.
They did.
Yeah.
They haven't brought it back. So, okay. All right, so we need more. We need more chairs.
If you move over some, you could come in here. This is good. I'll just sit on the wall.
Great. Yeah. Perfect. Perfect. And you can also use this chair, too. This
okay.
one.
Okay. Thank you.
If somebody else comes, I will also give up this chair and sit on the piano bench, which is fine. So, okay. So she's going to come in, and we'll just let you guys get set here.
And I'm right close to the door, just all right.
Hi.
Hi.
Good morning. Glad you could come.
Yeah.
So what's your name?
I'm Peggy.
Peggy. Okay. I'm Rob.
No.
Okay.
Good.
That's great. And is that like a nickname for Margaret or is it just Peggy?
Is what?
Is it a nickname?
For Margaret.
It's a nickname for Margaret.
Right, yeah. That's a hi, there's Kim too.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Hi.
Hi. Okay, good.
Center,
the same one.
Charlotte's getting a chuckle out of me.
Oh, of course.
Right.
Yeah,
so.
I know there's a couple of weeks in June you're gone.
That's right, yeah. And I won't be here Wednesday.
There's a chair right here. So you can sit there.
Okay, good. I'll sit right here. Thank you.
Yeah. All right, thanks, Kim. I'll meet
you. I saw the schedule. Long is taken off. It's no big deal.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, we'll get it straight.
All right, we will. I just wanted to make sure so we get you on the right.
Okay, I'm really all right. Thank you.
Okay.
All right. Good. Okay, so. All right, this is our Monday class, and we begin with sitting tall, just to focus and center into our breath. So, for starters, sitting tall, you make your spine, your neck, your head, and your trunk as straight as possible without exceeding your capacity with your eyes closed. And you come into breath awareness. Awareness of the feeling sense of the breath in the nostrils, the cool flow of the air as it first comes in the nostrils, and the sense of the dryness of the air, and the feeling of the breath as it flows in the nostrils, into the space behind the eyes. So you feel the breath coming in the nostrils, flowing as one stream into the region behind the eyes. Feel, sense the movement of the breath in the abdomen, in the navel region, the expansion with the inhalation, and the relaxation with the exhalations. Breathe naturally. So every cell in the body is breathing with you. Hiranyagarbha Garbhantam Shri feeling the sense of the breath coming in the nostrils, the wave of the breath in the body. Bring your awareness to the feet on the floor, sitting in the chair, the support of the chair, the sounds of the room, feeling of the surfaces of the skin. Continue to breathe naturally, and we'll transition into our practices for Monday. And this is the practice called Abhyanga, or self-massage. So we begin, if you're wearing glasses, now's a good time to take your glasses off, just set them on your end. Yeah, that's good. And bring awareness to the base of your thumbs. Raise your thumbs to the center of your forehead, just where your nose bridge joins your eyebrows. And smooth across your forehead with the base of your thumbs to either side, to your temples. And make a circle on your temples, just massaging your temples. And then start again in the middle of the forehead with the base of the thumbs. Smooth across the forehead to either side. When you get to the temples, make a nice circle there. And then once again, starting in the middle of the forehead where your hairline joins your forehead on the dome of the forehead. Smooth across the forehead to either side, to your temples, and make a nice circle there. And then lower your arms, let them rest. Let your arms rest and breathe. And you can rest at any moment in these exercises. Now bring your awareness to your hands and your thumbs and your index. Make little windows with your thumbs and your index fingers so you can massage your eyebrow ridge. So bring those to your eyebrow ridge and massage the upper edge of your eye socket and work your way to either side. You're kneading your eyebrows like you're making little loaves of bread, like bread dough. Just massage the bone area and work across to the temples. When you get to the temples, that's good. Make a circle there. Good, you can lower your arms and rest if you like. And we'll come again to work on the eyebrows one more time. So bring the thumb, index fingers to the, make little circles with your thumb, index fingers, and massage the upper eyebrow ridge so you can feel the edge of your eye socket there. It's kind of thick and round. You just massage across that over towards your temples. Make a circle at the temples. And do it again. Start in the middle where your nose bridge joins. So right in the middle of your forehead there, where your nose bridge joins your eyebrows, and massage those eyebrows. Good. And massage the temples. And then lower the arms. Good. That's good. So we're working on increased circulation on the face. So let us, for a moment, just rest the arms and come back into your back. This will begin to raise the temperature in your body as you hold your arms up. And now bring your awareness into your index fingers and lay them alongside your nose on the lower rim of your eye sockets. Without pressing on your eyeballs, press on that lower rim, release, press, release, press right where the bags under your eyes are. So you're pressing on that area, the lower rim of the eye socket, pressing, releasing, working your way across to either sides. Yeah, and then the temples, make a circle there. That's good. We do that again. Start right next to the nose. Just press on where the eye socket is. There you feel how it's different. It's a little bit of a sharper kind of edge to it. You're pressing pressing on the bone of the skull underneath the eyes. That's good, baby. That's great. And work your way across to the sides, over to the temples. Make a circle there. And then we do it one more time, right next to the nose, pressing on the lower rim of the eye socket, being careful not to press on the eyes. Press, release, press, release. That's good, very good. Press, release. We're gonna do this last movement over to the temples, make a circle there. Good, and then just lower your arms and let them rest. Good. Continue to breathe through the nose, so if that's possible, just breathe through your nose. Yeah, good, take some deep breaths. Nice, that's great, very good. Okay, now take the base of your thumbs, lay them alongside your nose again, and this time you're gonna massage your cheek muscles with the base of your thumbs and underneath your cheekbone and your upper jaw there over to the sides, over towards your ears. And when you get over to your ears, open your jaw, wiggle in a little bit, move your head side to side. Yeah, and use your hands to your base of your thumbs or your fingers to massage the area under your ears. You can move your head in a sort of figure eight pattern just to feel into those joints. Good. All right. Good. Lower the arms. And if you wear glasses, you can put them back on now. Yeah, so you can put your glasses back on, good. And now take the tips of your fingers to your upper lip, just below your nostrils, and massage through your lip, massage where your teeth go into your gums, and massage along the line of teeth to either side, pressing on, so you're actually pressing through the skin. Press through the skin. Yeah, close your lips and press through the skin, yeah on the outside, yeah. And work your way along the line of teeth, along to the sides, over towards your jaw. And when you get to your jaw, notice there's a muscle there. It's like a band of muscle, yeah. And kind of slide your fingers over that. Open your jaw, move your jaw, and then get onto the edge of your neck, this part of your neck right here. Yeah, that's good. Underneath your ears, and again, turn your head a little to side, and this would be where the doctor would check to see if you have any swelling. So just notice and say, okay, yeah, everything's good, or oh, I have a little swelling. Isn't that interesting? And just massage that side of the neck a little. Good. And you'll notice, lower your arms so you rest. You'll notice that you have a little more saliva in your mouth. Close your lips and notice. A little saliva. This is good for digestion. Enzymes, okay? So good for breakfast and the day. And now we continue, with the chin. So take your thumbs, put them underneath your chin, and use your fingers to massage your lower jaw. This time, you're massaging through your skin where your teeth go into your gums. So again, you just massage your gums, you kind of wiggle the teeth a little bit with your fingers, you work your way along the jaw with your thumbs underneath, stroke where your neck goes into your jaw, kind of like when you're a cat or a dog. It's very good. It begins to release endorphins, so it's great for feeling a little better. Just a self-massage, it always feels good when someone massages you and you're massaging yourself and getting very much the same reaction. Yeah, good. And then stop whenever you need to rest. Move your head again, a little side to side. Good, okay, and then lower your arms. Okay, so before we continue with the self-massage, now we do called lion pose. And this is Simha Kriya. This again will stimulate your salivation, your saliva glands for better digestion. So we begin by opening the mouth, stick out the tongue. Towards your tip of your chin. You can do it. It's scary. You open your mouth. Yeah, exactly. And then look out. Open your eyes wide. Look up through the tops of the eyes. It's quite a scary gesture. It's like the cats outside the forbidden gates, but it's very good. It relaxes the neck. So we're going to do it again. Good, keep breathing. And now this time, when we do it, we're going to remember a cat or a dog in the morning when it takes its stretch and it pulls its ears back along the side of its face, its eyes become slits, and the whole skin of the body is pulled towards the tail. And we put our palms down on our knees, spread your fingers like claws, grip the floor with your feet, draw your heart through, sit up tall, and you're going to exhale rapidly too, like a cat hissing. And you'll see, we'll try it a couple times. So exhale first and inhale deeply. Then open your face, open the eyes. And then you come up slowly. And that's quite a gesture right there. And as long as you come up slowly, it should be fine. You'll be in equilibrium. There are no counterindications, like if you have hypertension or detached retinas or glaucoma or any of those kinds of debilitations. This practice is totally fine. So let's do it again. It's good. It really stimulates your salivation, but it also stimulates your lower intestinal tract too. So it's often the case that you have a good bowel movement after this. Okay, so extend your fingers, sit up tall, draw your heart through. Good, that's great. Okay, that's great. Exhale deeply, inhale, and then go into the pose. That's good. All right, relax your face. Come up. And you can always do that if you're on the bus and need to scare somebody away.
I think of a lion up in the tree ready to attack.
Yeah, that's very, very true. It's like the panther sitting on the tree hissing. Okay, now counter pose is we squint our face. Squint your eyes towards your nose. Squint your cheeks, your lips. Squint everything towards your nose. Hold it while you continue to breathe. And you'll even notice you can squint your neck. You can begin to squint your toes, your legs, your hips, buttocks, torso. Squint your, make fists with your hands, your lower arms. Hold it, everything, keep breathing. You're like a piece of iron. And relax, good. Good, so we'll try that again. Hold your palms like you're gonna have a couple bowls of soup. Fold in your little finger, fold in your ring finger, fold in your second finger, that's it. Fold in your first finger, that's good. Fold in your thumb, make fists, and release. Make those fists as tight as you can. Make your arms tight so you maybe even shake the little shoulders tight. Grip the floor with your feet, your legs, your buttocks, your torso. Now squint your face. Keep breathing, squint your face. Close your eyes, hold it a little longer, one, two more breaths. Remember this. Good. Good. So when you bring contraction to a muscle, and then you relax it, it automatically has a relaxation response. So we're deliberately doing this to kind of flush circulation through the body. That's what our goal is here in the Abhyanga. Joints and glands practices. Okay, so let us continue now. Let's let the arms dangle. Make little circles for the shoulders. Good. And then make them a little bigger, like wheels. And then begin to bow in with your head as you come forward. And then open your heart up. Draw your shoulder blades onto your back. Good. So make them as big as you can. And begin to flex your spine. Yeah, good. So you're really arching. So you exhale, you bow in. Inhale, open up. Exhale. Good, okay. And then just come back to your neutral position. Nice, very good. Okay, now we're gonna tap our sternum with our fingers. So right where your shirt pocket is, tap the sternum, and remember that the sternum, that bone, is a major producer of red blood cells.
Oh, yeah.
kind of interesting. So you tap it to wake it up. You tap pretty vigorously. The thymus gland sits right underneath the sternum.
And that protects our heart.
Yeah, it protects our heart. And the thymus is very much involved in your endocrine system, too, so your immune system. Good, okay, and then with fists, pummel your lower rib cage and arch your spine a little to one side so you open up those ribs there. Good, and if you can use just any part of your hand, you can get to pummel a little bit into your kidney region. Good, yeah, just a little bit goes a long way. And do the other side. With the other hand, lean forward so that you can get around to your kidney region. Remember that? That's good. And work your way down towards your tailbone and your hips. You can get the sides of your hips there. A little hard to do with a walker. Good. Okay. And then let's do the right leg from the knee to the hip. Just you can pummel your upper leg with your fists. And then the sides, the inside edge there, switch to a karate chopping movement. So you're using like the sides of your hands, good. Then you can use your fingertips, so you get that little pokey feeling, and then actually a little slapping, just enough to give a smarting feeling. Again, we're waking up the neural connections there, good, okay. Massage the knee. So work around the knee joint, right around the patella and the edge, and rest when you need to. Yeah, that's good. That's good. It is brings a little exercise to the cardiovascular system, definitely to move the arms like that. So everything's good. So we just work on the knee there. Good. Marvelous. Good. Okay. Now, sitting tall, you're going to fold forward from the hip over that thigh, so you're laying your belly down on the thigh, and then you can reach down the leg just a bit, down that right leg towards your, yeah, reach down your leg, and massage your calf and the lower leg. Yeah, great, and some folks get all the way to their shoe and can press on the top of their foot there, and the ankle. You're just waking up the circulation there. You're massaging wherever your hands can reach. You can squeeze the muscles to the bone. It's good for your muscle, hand muscles to do that. You can move the muscles around the bone a little bit. And then sweep from your foot all the way up, just like you're putting on a big pair of stockings. Okay, all the way up to your hip. Okay, so you reach down and then you sweep up from your foot past your knee and your ankle. So it's like you're putting on a big pair of stockings. You reach down, use the broad surfaces of your hands, and press on the leg. Good. Keep going all the way up past the hip. Yeah, great. Okay, good. And then sit up nice and tall. And once again, relax your face. Let the breath come. Let your eyes close for a minute. Rest. Notice the difference between your right leg and your left leg. That's the sweet part of the practice, is to really notice how differently they feel and how you're waiting to do the other side. And we'll come back up to the surface with our eyes. To the left leg. So start by massaging the leg from the knee towards the hip. And yeah, good. Tap down. You can use your fists to pummel a little, or the flat surfaces of your hand. And then at a certain point, switch to a kind of karate chopping movement. So you have the edges of your hands. Good. And you're working from the knee towards the hip. So yeah, that's good. That's the way. From the periphery towards the midline to help with lymph flow, you know, the lymph system. So good, okay. And then switch to your fingertips, kind of like the monkey playing the piano. Or you could also use the flat surfaces of your hands to give that slapping on your leg. Slap. Yeah. Just enough to get a little smarter, not enough to hurt. Massage the knee, so work right around that left knee, and you'll work around the knee joint. So we're working, work around the patella. Good. Use your fingertips to feel the outline of that bone, the sides of the knee joint. You can even pick that leg up a little bit and move it just to feel where the joint is. Good. Marvelous. Great. And then let's go ahead and lean forward over that leg so we can reach down the leg and work on the shin and the calf muscles. You can press the muscles into the bones with your hands, the flat surfaces of your hands. Squeeze and release. Work down towards your ankles and even maybe the tops of your foot. You can press through your shoe with your fingers. Wherever you get to is fine. There's really no right or wrong. You're just getting down as far as you can. And then when you're ready, sweep the entire leg from your foot up past, like you're putting on a big pair of stockings, all the way up to your hips. Just sweep up it and then make one more pass, starting towards the foot. Excellent, that's great. And all the way up, just come all the way up. And you can press, I like to encourage you to press pretty hard with your hands. Really like you're pushing in there and really making that neural connection. And you rest whenever you need to. We stay within our capacity. Okay, marvelous. Let us sit tall again. And just let the eyes close. Come into the breath awareness, the flow of the breath in the nostrils. The movement of the breath in the body, like waves flowing through the body. And now, once again, open the eyes. Float the arms up to your shoulder height. Good, very good. Awareness in the hands and the wrists. As you exhale, fold the hands down. Nice, very good. Stretch the backs of the arms and inhale. Lift them up. Good. Very good. And exhale down. Make circles with the hands. That's it. Good. Yeah, good. And go down and reverse the direction. Go in the other direction. Good. Very nice. And then bring the palms together. Like a book. Open a book. Just, good. Like you're reading the book. And then fold the cover back. This. That's it. Yeah. Fold it open. Good. And then dive down, just like you're going to dive in a lake. Just like, good. That's good. And then reach up. Reach up. If your arms go up, and then bring your arms down to the sides. Good. And then just bring them back and rest. Very good. Okay. We'll do that one more time. Okay. So, palms together. Open the book. Fold the book open. All the way, take the backs of the hands together. Good, good. And then dive down, like you're gonna dive in the lake, fold forward, round in, and then up towards the sky, reach up, and take the shoulder blades onto the back, and bring the arms down, good. And let it rest again on your knees, good. Okay, good, so we've been working from the crown of the head to the soles of the feet, top to tail. Something called joints and glands practices. And Monday we do our massage, and then on Wednesday, not this week, I won't be here Wednesday. I know, I'm sad. Okay, but we worked through our spine. We've done a lot of things for our spine. We did our hands and our arms. Let's do our feet and our legs. So sit tall and raise your right leg up. Good. Yeah, good. Make circles with the foot. Good. Go the other way. Excellent. Good. Point the toes. Maybe make a circle with the lower leg, like a You're drawing a circle with your toes. Good. Okay, a little bicycling. A little bicycling movement. Good. You might, yeah, that's good. That's great. Great. Okay, that's great. And take it out to the side. Yeah, just a little bit is good. Just a little tiny bit. Yeah, good. Okay, good. And stop and rest whenever you need to. Good. Okay, good. Okay, now extend that leg. Yeah, push up. Yeah, make the legs straight. And now like you're doing an accelerator pedal, push on. Yeah, good. And then draw back. Good. Press down. Good. Draw back. Good. Okay, and then put the big toe down. Put the big toe down. Keep the heel up. And you're going in. Quickly. Yeah, good. Just like we're in a game. Like, okay, ready? Here we go. Ready? 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 Okay, good. Now. Ready? Ready? Yeah, good. Okay. I like that game. It's fun. Okay. Tap down that leg from the knee to the hip. Set it aside and sit nice and tall again. Like your anti-gravity muscles, you know, to make your spine long and so they're not slumping. And let's do the other side. So now your other leg, pick it up. Yeah, good, that's it.
You lift that leg.
Okay, all right, well, so it's all right. I'm gonna sit there so I can see. So you guys, you lift your leg, and you make some circles, and for you, Peg, just on the ground, just make some circles. Yeah, good.
Lift it up.
Yeah, and go the other way, right? Okay, good, that's good. Then rest. And if you're still in the air, you can make some circles. So what you do, when you're doing these exercises, you do a little bit and then you rest. And some folks keep doing it and, you know, within your capacity. Good. Okay, and now extend the leg. So you're doing a bicycling movement. Great. That's great. Okay, good. Good. And if you want to kind of get into the side of the hip, you can take the leg out to the side. And this is one thing for you guys, you can take your knee over a little bit if you want to try it, like you're going to take it over. That's going to do a little bit more for your core muscle there. So, all right, reverse that. Good. Okay. Rest. That's good. That's going to get you hot. And, you know, if you get a little perspiration, that's the idea. So extend that leg now. Good. And then press on the accelerator. Good. Draw back. Press. Yeah, good, nice. Okay, now make a fist with your toes. Make a fist with your toes inside your shoe. A fist with your toes.
Okay, it's kind of hard to do with a shoe.
I like it. It's like extra resistance. Okay, and then spread the toes inside the shoe. That's how you do it. Okay, and then again, grip inside the shoe. Good, like making a fist and then spread. Good, good. Okay, how about let's turn the sole towards the salon. Nice. Good one. Okay, and then towards the patio. Good. There we go. Okay, towards the salon. Good. And then towards the patio. Good. All right, now we put the big toe down. Keep the heel up, and we do this game again. Yeah. As fast as you can. Faster than the eye can see. Good.
Feel exertion.
Yeah. That's good, and it creates this little pumping action for the hamstring muscles, which you just don't really get that much exercise with that. So, okay, my, you did it. That was a good exercise, very good. So we finished the way we started with a few moments of silence and just sitting up tall. So sit as tall as you can. Let your eyes close within your capacity. Be breath is flowing in the nostrils. Feel, sense the cool breath coming in the nostrils, slightly dry, and moving into the space behind the eyes. Feel the breath moving the body. Feel the breath moving in the This body, you are not these senses, you are not this mind, but you have a body, you have these senses, you have this mind, you are a wave of beauty and bliss, a child of eternity. When we finish the class in a traditional manner, if you like, the palms together. Heart, say with all the thought in the head, all the above in the heart, the power of action in the hands. We say namaste.
Namaste.
And I thank you all so much for coming and practicing again today, our Monday class. And it seems like you're getting it figured out that talking about the schedule.